Peter Captain, the brother, and sophomore, his brother.
Well, good evening and welcome to Aurora for a football game against Chisholm Blue Streaks and the Mesabi East Giants. And it's parents' night, so we're trying to get things organized here. And I apologize for the quick start. There we go. I don't know, you can't hear that. And let's see if I can get my partner's not here. And I don't think you can hear the PA. Well, my partner Bill Crete is back from getting the starting lineups, and I'm going to hand this off to him. Well, they're doing this pretty quick, Bill.
Yeah, they're going right through it really fast.
I'm not sure where we are.
Well, okay, so we're with the players here right now. Number 3, Aaron Collins. His parents are Scott and Sherry Collins. Number 5 is Josh Lafreniere. His dad is with him tonight, Gary Lafreniere. Number 9, Zach Hellander. And his mom and dad are John and Shannon Hellander. Number 12 is Tyler Baraboo. And his parents are Chad and Sarah Baraboo. Number 20 is Joshua James, and his parents are Jim and Sherry James. Number 30 is Daniel Nygaard, and his parents are Christina and Aaron Nygaard. Number 32, Trent Broughton, his parents are Kristen and Troy Broughton. Number 56 is Sebastian Sabunia, and his parents are Cassie Burke and Nick Sabunia. Number 81 is Price Robertson, and his parents are Jody and Mitch Robertson. Number 55 and number 7, Colby and John Gravett. His parents are Jen Sale and Mike Gravett. And the sophomores, number 25 is Adam Erie, and his parents are Eric and Chris Erie. Number 51 is Mason Linnell, and his parents are Robin and Jeff Linnell. Number 54 is Cullen Green, and his parents are Deanna and Kevin Green. Number 64 is Sam Chapman, and his parents are Anita Beauregard and Brian Chapman. Number 65, Preston Carlson, and his parents are Julia and Brian Carlson. Number 75, Gabe Tourneau, and his mom is with him, Heidi Vaughn. Number 80 is Brendan Scott, and his parents are Melanie and Ted Olmsted, and Sarah and Chad Scott. And number 84 is Luke Mickelson, Deanna and Matt Mickelson. And junior is number 22, Hunter Herzog, his parents are Jen and Kevin Herzog. Number 63, Brent Quietnen, his dad's with him here tonight, Jeff Quietnen. And number 83 is Devin Anderson, and his mom's here, Jennifer Schweider.
I see we got a few players injured too.
Yes, we do. And I'm looking here, and I must have not got one of the sheets because I don't have any of the seniors'
really?
Parents listed here.
On the front, too? Front page?
No place. So I don't know what happened, Barton.
Oops.
Yeah.
And I don't have anything here, so.
Yeah.
So, sorry, folks.
Yeah.
We were delivered a missing page, not brought a missing page here. So
it's AWOL. Has anybody seen
I guess you can
senior page?
I guess you can name the players as seniors.
Yeah, Alex Marfiot, and his parents are coming to meet him.
Yeah.
Okay, number 66 is Reed Hassel.
Thank you.
No, it's homecoming week next week.
It's homecoming week next week, yes. And so we've got some festivities here we'll need off. And our last senior tonight is number 72, Eric Willett. And it looks like his mom and dad are coming out. And I don't know where that page would have gone to.
And there was only two. So.
There was only two. I never did get a third page, and I guess I should have asked, where's the seniors?
Well, that's a whole bunch of seniors and cheerleaders and parents. And
so it's a 2015 Parents Night.
Yep.
And quite a nice crowd lined up there. A lot of dedication to Mesabi East football.
Oh, yeah. Yes, you bet.
I mean, it takes a lot of dedication on parents' parts and players' parts, and it takes everybody to field a football team out here.
But we do apologize for the missing page.
Yeah, I don't, no idea where it went. But I do have the pages here on homecoming for next week.
Okay.
So we can maybe run down through some of this here while we're waiting to get the player introductions for the start of the game here. If we got some time, we got 4 minutes and counting.
Oh, I have the introduction too. So.
Okay. Well, maybe I'll let you go do that first, Barney.
Okay.
All right. Take it away.
Yeah, I got a pan out here. And like I said, we have the Chisholm Blue Streaks today. And, okay, hello everyone, and welcome to a Mesabi Sports Broadcast. It's September 18th, 2015, and this is Barney Kokel and Mr. Bill Crete with you for a Friday Night Lights football action. We are at Dolan Field in Aurora, and we have the 2-2 Chisholm Blue Streaks and the 1-3 Mesabi East Giants. I will start with the Giants. I'll start with the Blue Streaks. They are coached by Donnie Quirk with assistant Matt Nelson, Reggie Ducote, Sean Lewis, and Todd Rinke. The Blue Streaks started the season out pretty slow with two lopsided losses, but they have rebounded now with two straight big heavy blowout wins. The last week was over Barnum, 26-6. So they've come together now. The Streaks are loaded with seniors. They have 14 seniors, seven juniors. They were 2-7 last year, and up until this year, they have been playing nine man since the 2011 and 2012 season. But now they've jumped up to back up to 7A. They're playing 7A teams now. As for the Giants, of course, they're coached by Steve Beaver Grahams with Keith Mackey, John Skelton, Dave Hillman, Rob Hill, Matt Kruger, Will Thamenbongsga, Tim Soler, and Chris Shuck with all the stats. The Giants don't have a lot of upperclassmen to speak of to anchor the team, but they have a lot of potential and to be explosive, with senior number 42 Alex Marfiot doing most of the ball carrying for the Giants, and number 7 sophomore John Gravett behind center. The schedule for the Giants has been a tough one this year, and is a tough one, with Chisholm tonight, of course, and Deer River, Rush City, and Bram yet to play. And I think between all three of those teams, they might have one loss. Maybe two at the most, but so if the Giants, Bill, can stay away from turnovers, penalties, they could make it a game tonight. And I just want to remind everybody that once this game is over and it is uploaded to the Channel 2 in Virginia, it goes on, of course, Channel 2, Channel 5, and also if you want to pass this on, you can go and onto YouTube and on your computer, and you could punch in Mesabi East Sports, Mesabi East, that's all you need, and you'll be able to watch this game or any Mesabi East activities that we film. So that's within a 24, 36 hour period after the game here. So it's Friday, I would say by late Saturday it could be on the YouTube.
And that's pretty neat, really.
That is pretty neat. That's the fastest turnaround we can get when we do this delayed broadcast. So, but anyway, and it's a nice night.
Beautiful night here for football. You know, I've got some stats here that Chris Shuck was able to bring over to us. So we got some time here before the player introduction, so I might be able to get some of these stats off. First of all, here for the Mesabi East Giants, we have 137 rushes on the year for 558 yards. And we have some, I'm looking at some other stats in here. We've outscored the opponents 32-6 in the fourth quarter. So we've got some positive things
there. Positive things there, yes.
And we talked earlier that maybe just play the fourth quarter, but no, we can't do that. I was just kidding. So, all right, looks like we're going to have the starting introductions here. So we'll get ready for that.
And, of course, I think we do have the Legion here to do the...
For the honor guard.
Yes.
Okay, here's the starting lineup for the Chisholm Blue Streaks. Quarterback number 14, Joel Escarbo. Number 22, wide receiver, Skylar Appleman. Number 31, fullback, Grayson Hartshorn. Number 34, Jackson Rudolph, another wide receiver. Number 55, a center, Andrew Jagovich. Number 57, offensive tackle, Travis Tupa. Number 61, another offensive tackle, Colton Pruitt. Number 72, a guard, Darian Hartshorn. Number 75 is Ricky Hooper. Number 85, Justin Colbert, wide receiver. And number 86, also got him listed here as a running back, Matt Champa, with a wide receiver number. Head coach for the Chisholm Blue Streaks, Donnie Quirk, assisted by Matt Nelson, Reggie DeCoot, and Sean Lewis. And now for the Mesabi East Giants, the defense. Number 7, cornerback, sophomore John Gravett. Number 12, safety, ninth grader Tyler Baraboo. The junior at linebacker, number 22, Hunter Herzog. Another cornerback, a sophomore, number 25, Adam Erie. At defensive tackle, number 54, Cullen Green. Number 63, junior, another defensive lineman, Brent Quaitinen. Number 64, sophomore, Sam Chapman. Another defensive lineman, number 66, senior, Reed Hossel. Linebacker, junior, number 70, Levi Skelton. Number 72, defensive end, senior, Eric Willett. And another linebacker, sophomore, number 80, Brennan Scott. And the head coach for the Mesabi East Giants, Mr. Steve Grams, assisted by Keith Mackey, John Skelton, Dave Hillman, Rob Hill, Matt Kruger, Will Thamavungza. And, of course, Chris Shuck does the stats. All right, and our national anthem will be played here with the high school band playing it under the direction of Mr. Josh Peterson. And we have the honor guard doing the flag. Thank you. All right, and a nice job by the high school band. It's the national anthem.
It's a little different from 2 weeks ago, Bill. We have jackets on now.
Oh, yeah, and layers.
Yeah.
You bet.
But it's still a beautiful night. Field's in excellent shape. We had some rain this week, so it greened up.
Mm-hmm.
Greened the field up again.
Yeah, it looks really nice out there. Grass is growing nice and lush. Well, it looks like the Mesabi East Giants will be kicking off on the left side of the field, and the Blue Streaks will be receiving on the right. Back deep for the Blue Streaks to receive is number 36, Tyler Copeland, and number 21, Zach Skurla. Kicking off for the Giants, number 33 is Levi Skelton. And we got the kick, and it's a little roller right through the middle. Picked up back there by Copeland, and he's going right off down the middle, and looks like he's going to go all the way in for a touchdown on the opening kickoff. And he does. I don't see any flags. So on the opening kickoff, number 36, Tyler Copeland, just juts right up the middle and down the left sideline for a score. 6-0.
Well, that didn't take long.
That didn't take long at all.
How long? Did he run that in
12 seconds.
Well.
Boy. Well, it's not the start we wanted for the game tonight, but it is what it is, so we have to go from here. All right, the Streaks are lining up here to go for two. It's like they got a double tight end formation here. Single set back. Player in motion, but somebody must have jumped. Yep. Oh, we got offside.
It's on the Giants, so.
So somebody lined up in the neutral zone, so it'll be half the distance to the goal. So instead of going from the 2 yard line, we're going from the one. All right, under center is Joe Lescarbo for the Blue Streaks. Again, player in motion. Fake the handoff and just a straight dive into the middle, and it's good. So it's 8-0 Chisholm Blue Streaks right off the bat, 12 seconds into the first quarter.
I didn't even have time to blink my eyes.
Well, I looked down to try to get his name on the chart here, and next thing I know, he's sprinting up the middle and going up the left sideline, so.
Well, like you said, it's not the start that the Giants wanted, but this is what they've been dealt with. Now they're just going to have to come right back.
Got to be resilient.
Yep, that's right.
All right, so the Blue Streaks will be kicking off from the 40-yard line. Giants will be back to receive here on the left. We've got, who's back here? It looks like, looking at the number there, I think that's number 7, John Gravett. And on the other side, number 25, Adam Erie.
Yeah, I don't know if that was a design play on the opening kickoff is the squib, or was it just a...
I don't think so. I think he just didn't quite hit it cleanly. All right, here's the kickoff, and it's kind of a squibber, picked up in front here by number 33, Levi Skelton. And he rolls ahead for a couple more yards before he's tackled and brought down by the Blue Streaks. So the Giants will take over, first and 10 from their own 42-yard line, and we'll see what kind of plays Coach Graham has set up for tonight. That was like number 88 on tackle for the Blue Streaks, but I don't have a player at number 88 on the rosters. So something happened there. All right, the Giants are out of the wishbone. We got a wide receiver to the left side of the field. Quick handoff there from Tyler Baraboo. to Alex Marfiot, and he bowls ahead for a pickup of about 6 yards on here. So nice run off of the right tackle for Marfiot to start the game. Yeah, we have a change at quarterback for tonight's game. Tyler Baraboo is in.
I see that, and I was just going to correct that from what I said.
Well, you didn't know. Oh, and I didn't have a chance to get up here and point that out before the game got started. So, all right, again, out of the wishbone, second down and 4. Wide receiver, Adam Erie out to the left. Fake handoff to the fullback. Give us to number 7, Gravett. And he sweeps to the left side, and he picks up about another 6 yards and a first down for the Giants. So a nice job by the Giants here on the first offensive series to move the chains.
Well, I can see why the switch was made, because you have Gravett in the backfield now as a regular actual ball carrier. So
right.
Gives him a little bit more speed and...
And some of that is due to the senior Josh Hodak's injury, too.
Oh, okay.
So you've got to move players around when you have injuries. Okay, hand off to the fullback. I believe that's Levi Skelton. Looks like he picks up about 3 yards before he's mass tackled in the middle of the field. Second down and 8. Giants in the middle of the field from their own 44-yard line. And the Giants running out of the wishbone. Tyler Baraboo again with the handoff. Quick pitch outside to Marfiot. He's going to make the corner. He does. Can he stay in bounds? Looks like he is. Cut back to the inside. Horse power a little bit. And he's brought down about the 2-yard line. So a beautiful run by Alex Marfiot. I don't see any flags.
Yeah.
So it looks like the play is going to hold up.
Nice run. Nice.
Looks like a 40-yard run off the right side. So Baraboo did a nice job, hung on to the ball, pitched it just at the right time, and Alex took it off.
Well, that's what we were looking for, Bill. Is
exactly what we needed right here to counteract that quick touchdown that the Blue Streaks had on the opening kickoff. All right, so we're on the right hash mark. Again, Adam Erie, wide out to the left. Wishbone formation. Tight end to the right side. Alex Marfiot, straight ahead run to the right side. And he's in the end zone for a touchdown. So the Giants answer back with a touchdown on their first offensive possession. So it's 8-6.
Well, that's got to put a little spark into the Mesabi's Giants here.
Well, this is really good. It's our first points of the season in the first quarter.
First quarter, there we go.
So, lots of firsts here in this game tonight. All right, looks like the Giants are going to go for 2. Try to tie it up. I'm looking to see here why they're moving the ball. Oh, yeah, moving it to the middle of the field. That's what it was. They had it on the right.
Hash mark?
Yep. Okay, Giants getting out of the wishbone. 2 wide receivers out here to the right. Baraboo back to pass. And his pass is a little bit too long, incomplete. And so with that, 9:31 of the first quarter, it's the Blue Streaks 8, the Giants 6. So a lot of scoring here early, Barney.
Yeah. And now the Giants, of course, have to kick off, and let's hope we don't have a repeat.
Oh, we got to make sure we make some tackles out here. And, of course, I know what Coach Grams does here a little bit on the special teams. He tries to get some of the other players into the game, and, you know, it's good experience for them.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But sometimes if they don't plug up their lane like they should, you know, all it takes is one quick scat through and shoom.
But that was an excellent drive by the Giants and a great run by Alex Marfiot.
Some well-executed plays. I think we had positive gains on every play except for the 2-point conversion, which was incomplete. All right, once again back deep for the Blue Streaks is number 21, Zach Skirla, and number 36, Tyler Copeland.
And we have a nice crowd in the stands.
Wonderful crowd.
And of course, the band is here too.
Band is here, and I can smell the barbecue going over there. Oh, does that smell good? All right, Levi Skelton to kick off for the Giants. Here's the kick. Again, a squib right down the middle. Picked up by the front man, number 31. Cuts over to his left. Again, some missed tackles. He comes up the left side, and he's corralled there by Levi Skelton, number 33. And number 80, Brennan Scott. So the tackle is made at the 42-yard line. It'll be the Blue Streaks ball, and the Giants 42, first and 10. So again, we had some missed tackles on the kickoff. Allowed the Blue Streaks to get some good yardage and good field position.
Well, this is Chisholm's first play from scrimmage.
Yes. Okay, in motion is number 34. Swinging over to the right, couple of cut moves to the outside. And there he's met by number 33, Levi Skelton, for the tackle. A gain of 9, second down and 1. That's Jackson Rudolph, a senior. 5'9", 165 pounds. Blue Streaks coming up to the line. Again, they run double tight formation. Rudolph on this side, number 34. Goes in motion. Kick off to Rudolph around the right side. He's partially tripped up from behind, but he still gains about 4 yards, 5 yards. And it's going to be a first down on the play for the Blue Streaks. They're going to move the chains. It'll be first and 10 from the 34-yard line. 27-yard line.
Well, let's see if the Giants' defense can stiffen up here and hold them.
Ball's on the right hash mark. Okay, number 21 goes in motion. Fake handoff. Quick inside to Copeland. Cuts it to his right, back to his left. And
he's in.
He's into the end zone. So a 27-yard run by 36, Tyler Copeland. And the Blue Streaks are back in the end zone again. 14-6 here in the first quarter. And he just kind of weaved his way through the defense and got into the end zone.
And they're going for two again.
Gonna go for two. Again in motion is Skirla. He almost tackled in backfield.
And he's in though.
But he gets across for the 2-point conversion. And so it's 16-6. 8:06 to go in the first quarter. Well, we got to come up with some way of stopping these guys.
Yeah, well, you know, when you have some missed tackles and that doesn't help, and you know, and it's a growing year too for the Giants as far as underclassmen go. You know,
oh, we're very young. Yes.
Yep, very young. So,
and of course, now we've had some injuries too. So now you're filling in with even more inexperienced players. So it takes a little while to figure out what you have to do at the varsity level.
Yes.
Because the game is a lot faster than it is at lower levels. All right, the Blue Streaks will be kicking off from the 40. Giants are lining up. We got Crevette, number 7, back deep. Erie, number 25, back. Levi Skelton. And I'm not sure who the other. I think it's Brendan Scott, number 80, on the other side. And here's the kick. Nice booming kick. Picked up by Adam Erie. Comes to the right side, and he's met and tackled at the 21-yard line.
Nothing going there.
Nope. So they're setting up the chains. It'll be the Giants' ball, first and 10 from their own 21-yard line.
Well, let's see if they can have the same result here, just a little bit further back.
Yeah. Yep, you just got to, you know, keep up the momentum here on offense and match them point for point as close as we can. Again, running out of the wishbone. Fake the dive ahead. Marfiot with it, straight up the middle, cuts to his right. Then picks up about 7 yards, 8 yards on the carry. So nice run by senior Alex Marfiot. It's going to be second down and 3 from the 29. Okay, one wide receiver out wide to the left. Adam Urey. Tyler Baraboo under center. Hand off to Levi Skelton, straight ahead. And he's close to a first down. They're stopping the clock here to check, see if he's got enough. Yep.
Yep, he does.
He got the first down, so nice job by Levi Skelton to get the yardage.
Move the chains.
Yep.
Good job.
So that'll be first and 10 now from the 34. Okay, quick blitz by the Blue Streaks. They get their hands up and the pass is knocked down. So incomplete pass, it'll be second down and 10. One of the things with Tyler Baraboo at quarterback,
he's
nice
got
and
height.
Tall. He's about 6'4". And you know, you can see over the top of the line. And
but they still managed to block that, too.
They still managed to block it, yep. But he's, you know, only a ninth grader, so he's got a lot of experience to pick up, and he's going to gain it quickly here. All right, the Giants are switching here, running out of the eye. Two wide receivers here to the right. Hand off to the tailback, Marfiot, and he picks up 9, maybe 9.5 yards. He's close to another first down. So it's all going to depend on here whether it's a left or a right foot spot. Okay, it looks like he's going to be just short, so it's going to be about third and a yard. Third and a short yard. So we're moving the ball, Barney.
Yeah, right now.
Okay, again, the Giants line up in the eye. Two wide receivers here to the right. Scott and Gravett, Adam Erie on the left. Straight ahead dive, Marfiot. Yeah, he's pretty close.
Forward progress there, maybe?
Yeah, that corner's about 7 yards.
I don't know. Depending on where he got the spot, so looks like it's going to be a little short, huh? Like,
yep.
They're going to measure?
Yep, they're going to bring the chains out and check.
This could be, if he's a little bit short, this could be...
This will be an interesting call here if we don't get the first down because we're still on our side of the field, only at the 44-yard line. So if we don't get it, the Blue Streaks will have a short field. So we'll see. And they're going to stretch the chains. He's got it by more than a length of football.
Yeah.
So first down for the Giants from the 44-yard line. So we move the chains, keep the ball in our possession. We're on the right hash mark. We got 5 minutes, 59 seconds here in the first quarter. All right, again, we're out of the wishbone. Tight end to the right. Straight dive ahead. Nope, fake it, dive ahead, Gravett with it. Running off to the left side, but he stretched out and picks up maybe a yard.
He couldn't quite get around that corner there, Bill.
Couldn't quite turn it. Blue Streaks did a nice job of stretching it out.
You have quite a sunset way back in the yonder.
It's just beautiful.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can see it on the screen there.
Yeah, it's pretty hard.
Yeah. All right, here's the Giants, second down and 9. Option coming this way, pitch out Tamar Fiat picks up a couple more yards.
Big third down here.
Yep. Third down and about seven.
Yes, yes.
Blue Steak strung it out again, so he couldn't get to the outside, and he had to cut it back up inside. And that's right into the heart of the defense. All right, third down and long. We'll see what kind of play Coach Grahams calls. Okay, back to pass. Looking like a screen pass. Oh, no. And it's picked off by number 34.
And he has clear
Jackson
sailing.
Jackson Rudolph.
Oh, no.
Oh, nice job by number 42, Alex Marfiat, to come across the field and make the tackle.
At the 10-yard line,
yep,
huh?
At the 10-yard line. So
I thought he had clear sailing.
I thought he did, too. And Alex come all the way across from the other side to make the tackle. So nice job by Marfiat to save the touchdown.
Well, we were talking about that earlier in the game, penalties, and which hasn't been a problem yet, but turnovers are a key.
Yeah, turnovers really hurt.
So,
and that there looked like he just threw it right to him. He didn't see the coverages that the linebackers had dropped into, and it was picked off.
Well, a little bit, you know, ninth grade, a little bit inexperienced there.
Yep. Like I said, everything's a little faster. Okay, fake handoff, roll around. Here's the pass into the back of the end zone. Too long, incomplete, so it'll be second down and goal from the 10. So it was a nice little play there, a little fake pitch out and roll out. And had a guy wide open, overthrew him. Copeland in motion, pitch off, hand off to the inside. Here comes Surla.
Oh,
okay, we got some kind of a penalty in there.
Right to the goal line it was. So it looks like we have a hold.
All right, so it's going to come back. Jim Johnson, the head referee out here tonight, giving the Giants defense the options. And they're going to take the penalty. It looks like it's a 10-yard penalty, so it's going to move the ball all the way back to the 14-yard line. So it's going to be second down and goal from the 14. So second down and goal. Copeland is outside. Fake the handoff to Skirla.
Holding it.
Archambault is back. Here comes the pass. And he throws it out of the back of the end zone. So it'll be third down and goal from the 14. Third down and goal. We'll see what kind of play Coach Quick comes up with for the Blue Streaks. Okay, once again, single back in the backfield, couple of wings in motion. Scarborough, quick hitter across the middle, snuffed out real nice by number 66 of the Giants. And that's Reed Hossel with the tackle in the backfield for the loss. So it's going to be fourth down and goal.
Well, I would say that this is four down territory here for the
Streaks. Oh, yeah, they're going to go for it.
So
fourth down and goal from the 18. So a nice job by the Giants defense. Get a loss in the backfield. Can we do it again, Barn?
Certainly.
Can we hold him?
Certainly.
Here we go. In motion is Copeland. Fake handoff. The Scarble looking to pass, gets a pass ahead to number 31.
And he's in.
And he's into the end zone for a touchdown.
And no flags.
No flags. So that was Grayson Hartshorn with the catch.
Well, it was kind of like a little pitch or something, you know, a forward pitch.
You know, I have to question right now, I'm looking, was he over the line of scrimmage? But there's no flags, so apparently not. So an 18-yard touchdown pass to Hartshorn. Yeah, makes it 22-6 here in the first quarter. Once again, the Blue Streaks are going for two. In motion is Copeland. Dives straight ahead. And that's Grayson Hartshorn, fullback, with the run. So with that, it's 24-6. 3:11 to go in the first quarter. Could be a high-scoring affair, Barn.
Could be.
Well, you got to get some kind of a play going here to try to get the crowd back in the game. It's pretty quiet.
Well, the Giants have been having some luck on the ground. You know, they've been picking up some first downs, and they just an unfortunate interception there.
Yeah. Well, anytime you got third down and long, it's a tough field position because the defense knows you got to get that yardage, and you just kind of threw it away in the last possession. All right, kicking off for the Blue Streaks is number 37. And that's Corbin Jones, sophomore. Back to return is John Gravett and Adam Erie. And there's the kick. Side wobbling, picked up by Gravett. Coming up the right sideline, cutting back to his left. And he's met and tackled there at the 33-yard line. So the Giants will take over first and 10 from their own 33. And they gave us forward progress all the way up to the 35, so it'll be first and 10 from the 35.
Yeah. We'll take every yard we can get.
Yep.
First quarter is winding down here.
Yep. We got 3:04 to go. And of course, the clock stops with every incomplete pass. All right, Giants. Got two wide receivers here to the right. They sweep to the left side.
Now he just might have gone back to the line or just short.
Yeah. All right, so it's going to be second down and 10. They're on the left hash mark. Giants trying to mix up some things. Again, we got wide receiver coming out here to the right side. Again, we got a blitz by the Blue Streaks plugging up the middle.
Stacked up there, Bill.
You're just nothing going. Oh, boy. Some kind of a play going on out here. Brendan Scott, the wide receiver, got tied up with one of the corners. I don't know what that was all about or what they're going to call. I'm sure he was just trying to block downfield, but it all tangled up. Okay, so we got a personal foul called on number 34 after the play. So that's going to be a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down. So that's going to move the ball up to midfield, past midfield, actually into the Blue Streaks territory on the 48. So it'll be first and down for the Giants right there. Okay, again, Giants out of the wishbone. One wide receiver to the left. Fake handoff to the fullback. Give to 42, Alex Marfiot. Gets good running room there. Picks up about 8 yards. So that'll be second down and 2 or 3. Looks like a gain of 7 is what they're giving him.
Nice run.
Real nice run.
He's racking up some yards.
Yes, he is.
In the first quarter.
Yeah, he's probably got, what, about 60 yards already?
Could be, yeah. 42
on that near touchdown run there in the first possession. Okay, double tight end this time for the Giants. Out of the wishbone. Looks like the Blue Streaks jumped. So it looks like encroachment.
Now that should give the Giants a first down if it's on, and it is on the Streaks.
Yep.
First and 10 for the Giants.
So we're moving the chains. Okay, wishbone, Levi Skelton at the fullback, John Gravett and Alex Murphy out in the backfield. Tyler Baraboo under center. Gets a snap. Straight ahead dive. Levi Skelton, looks like he picked up about 8. So again, nice run by the Giants. They're hitting, picking up yardage.
The front line of the Giants are pushing the Chisholm Blue Streaks around a little bit right now.
Yeah, and the Blue Streaks got some big boys up front there. I mean, wow. So we're doing a good job of sealing them off, making a hole. Again, double tight end. Second and short. Handoff goes to Gravett, I think. Yep, looks like he picked up about 3.
Another first down.
Yep. All right, moving the chain. So it's going to be first and 10 from the 25.
Field is getting shorter for the Giants here.
Yeah. Well, you can pick up 4 or 5 yards on a crack. You move right down the field. Okay, 10 seconds and counting here in the first quarter. Are they going to get the playoff?
Nope,
they're not. Okay, so there you have it. End of the first quarter, it's the Chisholm Blue Streaks 24 and Mesabi East Giants 6. All right, so they're going to be changing end of the fields here. And while they're doing that, Barney, that's going to give me a chance to talk about the homecoming activities that are coming up this next week for the Giants.
Sounds good.
So we've got some crazy days coming up for homecoming. On Monday the 21st, it will be Lazy Loungewear Day.
That sounds like what I should be in, lazy loungewear.
I don't know. I don't have any lazy loungewear.
Well, I'll tell you what.
I just wear blue jeans.
I'll tell you what. If we do the game next Monday, the volleyball game, what if we just wear pajamas?
Well, you can. I'm not. All right. Tuesday the 22nd is Marvel Disney Day. So Marvel Comics or Walt Disney Character Dress Up Day. Wednesday is going to be Where's Waldo Day? Dress up like Waldo. And of course I was asking, what Waldo is.
I'll have to get the book out. I got it in my truck. Where's Waldo?
I guess that kind of dates how old I am. Thursday the 24th is Whiteout Blackout Dress in All White or All Black Day.
You just need some grandkids.
Yeah. And then of course Friday is the Giant Pride All School Colors.
I can borrow you a couple of grandkids if you
you have several there. All right, Barney. All right, here's the Giants. First down and 10 here in the second quarter. Handoff is to Marfiot, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. So it's going to be second down and about 12. So that play was just snuffed out right away. No room to run.
So we have second down, and did they lose a little bit down there?
Yeah, second and 12. All right, again, we're running a double tight end, wishbone. Tyler Baraboo with the snap, fake handoff, rolls off here to the left. Looking downfield, wide open receiver. Just out of his reach. Just a tad bit long. It was there.
I thought Baraboo was going to keep that and run.
At first, but he saw Adam Erie was wide open down there, and his throw is just a little bit long. So it'll be third down and 12. That was a nice play.
Yeah.
Nicely executed other than the pass.
Well, it was a nice pass there. Just a little bit.
Yeah, he had nice tight spiral on it. All right, so third and long. We've got Adam Erie lined up here to the left. Again, Wishbone, one tight end to the right. Blue Streaks looking like they're going to blitz here. Coming hard. Quick hitter. Alex Murphy out with the run. Looks like he picked up about four or five. It's going to be fourth down. It's like fourth down and eight from the 29-yard line. 24-yard line, excuse me. All right, we're on the right hash mark. Two wide receivers to the right. Brendan Scott on the outside, John Gravett in the slot, Adam Erie here. Two backs in the backfield. Back to pass, looking downfield, and the ball is batted down, incomplete. And so with the incomplete pass, it will go over to the Blue Streaks on downs.
I didn't see if someone was open downfield.
I couldn't tell either, but the ball was batted down at the line, actually right in the backfield. Our blockers up front have got to chop those guys so they can't get their hands up in the air and give Tyler a chance to throw. All right, first and 10 for the Blue Streaks from their own 24-yard line. Blue Streaks again running double tight ends. Single back in the backfield. Okay, in motion's number 86. He gets the pitch. Number 86 tackled in the backfield for a loss. Nice tackle there by number 63 for the Giants, Brent Quietenen. He just reached out one big arm and just grabbed him and threw him right down. 86 is Matt Champa. Matt Champa is a senior. All right, so a loss of four, so it's second down and 14. In the Blue Streaks, in their double tight formation. And Scarborough, the senior. Straight dive, straight ahead to number 31.
Still moving.
Having a hard time finding him. Grayson Hartshorn with the run. And almost the first down there, he picked up about 12. So it's going to be third down and two. Nothing fancy there, Barney. Just a straight ahead dive.
Well, let's see if the Giants can come up big here now and hold them, because I don't think this is four down territory for Chisholm.
Well, it's hard to say. We haven't had them backed up yet tonight, so hopefully somebody can come through and make a play. Motion number 21, Skirla.
I'd have to say it's going to back up Chisholm.
Yep. Illegal procedure.
Yep.
I think they had two people in motion there. Somebody was leaning. So it's going to be third down and 7. Again, from the Blue Streaks 28-yard line. On the left hash mark. 24-6 here in the second quarter. The Blue Streaks up on the Giants. Okay, looks like a pass play. Long pass downfield. Ball's in the air. Picked off by Tyler Baraboo. And he's knocked out of bounds over on the 42-yard line.
Nice.
But I see a flag in the backfield back here, so hold everything. We'll see what the penalty is. All
Most of that is holding, though, usually, but...
You know, we'll see what the call is going to be. Official still sorting through it, talking to the Blue Streaks. Okay, so it looks... Uh-oh. Personal foul.
Oh, so offsetting.
Offsetting play. Penalties here.
Repeat the down?
Right, yep. So it's going to be third down and 7 once again. Oh, boy, you hate to see that.
Yeah.
You know?
Tyler had a nice interview with that lanky, tall body of his.
Yeah, he reached up there and plucked it out of the air very nicely. I was kind of teasing him a little bit in class this past week. I said, you got to hang on to that a little bit there. And
he did.
He finally did it. All right, third down and 7 on the repeat of the play. In motion is number 34, a straight dive ahead. And it looks like Hartthorne's going to get the first down. So they're going to move the chains. It'll be first and 10 for the Blue Streaks. It looks like it's going to be from the 36-yard line. So those were huge personal offsetting personal fouls for the Giants. Gave the Blue Streaks another opportunity, and they cashed in for the first down.
8:14 left to go in the second quarter here. Chisholm in command right now.
Okay, we got motion, and they give us to the motion man. He comes around the right side, cuts back into the middle, still on his feet, and
he outrun him.
He's going to go. Can he get caught? Adam Murray with the shoestring attempt, but it's not enough. Into the end zone for the touchdown. So what do we got? 50, 60, about a 62-yard touchdown run. Tyler Copeland, sophomore, with the touchdown run.
That makes it 30 to 6.
30 to 6. So far, we just don't have an answer. No. Got to make some tackles.
Well, Chisholm's got some speed. Once they get to the outside,
they're gone.
They can put the afterburners on in.
Okay, once again, Blue Streak's going for 2. In motion, fullback.
And he's in.
Yep. Give this to the fullback. And that's Hartshorn, Grayson Hartshorn with the run. So 32-6, 7:48 to go in the second quarter.
Well, that double penalty there hurt the Giants because Tyler Baraboo had the interception there, and the offsetting penalties had Chisholm repeat the down. So
yeah, that was a nice pick, and we had some momentum there. And
yeah,
it was all for nothing. Well, we're going to have to try to get some momentum going here again. I'll pick it up. Blue Streaks will be kicking off here from left to right. Giants will be back to receive. Adam Erie, number 25. Number 7, John Gravett. In the second line, we got Brendan Scott, number 80, and number 33, Levi Skelton. So we got 4 guys back. Jones to kick off. And a nice boom and kick picked up by Gravett. Coming up the right side. He's got a little running room. Can he turn the corner? Nope. And he's tackled. Looks like about at the 42-yard line.
Well, the Giants will start in pretty good field position here.
Yeah, almost midfield. First and 10 for the Giants at the 41. When they go to the opposite side of the field, it's hard to see exactly where they're tackled.
Where they are, yeah. Yeah, yep.
That was a nice return by John on that carry. I should say kickoff. Okay, one wide receiver here to the left. Straight dive ahead.
Oh, and there was a fumble, I think, on the play.
Uh-oh.
And back to Chisholm.
Yep. Oh, boy.
So that is a second turnover for the Giants tonight with an interception and now a fumble. And it's right on midfield, it looks like.
Yep, right at midfield.
The Giants did not need that.
No, no. We needed to run some time off the clock and run down the field and score, but wasn't to be. All right, so now let's see if we can tighten up our defense and make a stop here and force them to punt. Okay, back to pass. The Scarbo, the pass incomplete. Stops the clock. It'll be second down and 10. So no open receivers there for the Blue Streaks, so he had to throw it away. In motion is number 86. Yeah, Chapa.
Whoa.
Quick pitch out to the back, almost over his head. The Giants are in the backfield, however, to make the tackle. So that's Reed Hossel, number 66, and number 63, Brent Quitinen, in on the tackle.
Big loss. Yep.
It's like about a 7-yard loss. Looks like we got a flag on the penalty on the play here, though.
I'm guessing it's on the Streaks.
Looks like it. Oh, it's the illegal shift.
So that's declined.
Penalty is declined, so they'll be taking the play. And so it's a 7-yard loss, and so it'll be third down. Should be third down here in about 16. All right, let's see if we can come up with another play. Okay, motion number 36. He gets the handoff, coming around the right side, and he's met there by about three different Giants. Quitinen and number 72, Eric Willett, and Reed Hossel in on the tackle. So a nice job by the Giants to sniff that one out, make a stop. So it's going to be fourth down and about 17. And it looks like the Blue Streaks are going to be punting. Number 22, Skylar Appleman Jr. is back to punt. And it looks like John Gravett and Adam Erie back to receive the punts.
Nope.
Poor snap, low. Nice kick, though. Adam Erie calling for a fair catch, and then he runs away from the ball. And it takes a big Blue Streak roll all the way back down to the 15-yard lines. So the Giants will take over first and 10 from their own 15.
I think that was the first punt of the game.
Yes.
By either team.
Yep. So it was a nice high booming punt.
Yeah, he's actually kind of lucky that he got was able to get that off.
Yeah, he was, because that snap just rolled back to him. All right, here come the Giants. Adam Erie lined up here wide to the right. Brendan Scott to the right. Erie to the left. Gravett's in the slot. Quick straight dive ahead to Marfiot. Picks up about 3 yards. Second down and 7. Okay, this time Giants going with a double tight end with the wishbone formation. Blue Streaks send in a blitz. Gravett with it. Uh-oh, another fumble.
I think
a loose ball picked up by The Blue Streak's number 72. He says, I got a touchdown, but...
I thought he picked it right out of his arm.
It looks like it, yeah. No, let me see here what they're going to call. Because if he took it right out of his hands, then it's a touchdown.
Well, it's Chisholm's ball. Because I don't think there was a fumble. I think he just pulled it right out of his arm.
Well, if he pulled it out of his arm...
He should have been able to keep going.
Yeah, it should have been a touchdown if he just stripped it out of there. They're saying he must have touched the knee down, because that's all it takes to be down is the knee. And so it'll be first down for the Blue Streaks from the Giants' 19-yard line.
Another first turnover for the Giants.
Third turnover tonight. Okay, motion by Skrla. Skrla gets
in.
Straight ahead by Hartzell. Hartzell in for the touchdown.
He fumbled the ball.
He fumbled it, but he was already in.
Yeah.
As soon as he crosses the plane to the goal line, he's in. So with that touchdown run, it's 38-6.
With what's left here?
Yeah, we got about 5:08 to go here in the first quarter.
With this new booth, I can't see the scoreboard, so I'm going to have to cut a hole.
That'll go over there. Oh boy. Well, I just try to sneak around the corner here and look to see how much time is left and see what the score is. Well, the Blue Streaks are going to try an extra point. The Scarbo is to hold. Okay, we got a penalty. Alec Pacenda, ninth graders, is going to try the extra point. Oh, excuse me, it's number 37 and got the wrong one. It's Corbin Jones. All right, so we'll line up and try it again. Okay, there's the snap, there's the hold.
Blocked.
And it's blocked in the middle. It never did get up high enough to get going. You know, those kicking those extra points, there's so much that can go wrong. And it's only a point.
Yeah.
You know, if you get it. See where the NFL this year has moved it back?
Moved it back, yeah.
That's interesting. They had four, first weekend of play, they had four missed extra points. And they had eight all of the NFL season last year. So, only the first game, 15 more to go, could be a lot more. But, back to the high school play here, it'll be the Blue Streaks kicking off to the Giants. 38-6 is the score, second quarter. You know, getting back to those extra points, you know, the snap has to be perfect.
Oh, yeah.
The catch has to be perfect. The hold has to be perfect. The kicker's got to get under it. And your guy's still got to make the blocks. And here's the kickoff over to Adam Erie on the left side. Coming straight ahead. Cuts it back into the middle. It looks like he's got some room to run. And he stood up and blown backwards. But he returned it to about the 31-yard line. So the Giants will take it over from there, first and 10.
Well, I think all three turnovers were turned into touchdowns for the Blue Streaks.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they were. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, usually that's the case. You know, when you get a turnover, it's usually in a poor field position and short field, and they can take it in easily. All right, the ball is on the left hash mark. Giants send one wide receiver out to the left. Wishbone offense. Tyler Baraboo with a pitch out to Mark
Fiat.
Another fumble. And it looks like Giants recover it. Mm-hmm. All right, so it's a huge loss. Backs the ball all the way up to the Giants. It looks like to their own 15-yard line. So it's going to be second down and about 25, 26.
A long way.
It's a long ways, yeah. All right, two wide receivers to the right, one to the left. Single back in the backfield. Quick pass off to the side. Gravett with it, breaks one tackle, scoots up the right side.
You got part of it back.
Got part of it, yep. So it's going to be third down and long. Ball's on the right hash mark. Giants trying to get some offense going here. Two receivers here to the left. Baraboo back to pass. Doesn't see anything, runs straight ahead. Oh, we got another fumble. He stripped, and it's going to be Blue Streak's ball.
That's number four. Now, we talked about that. They can't have the turnovers, and they have.
Yep. Boy, oh boy.
Deep in Mesabi East territory.
Looks like it's on the 25-yard line.
Yeah.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Blue Streaks, trying to add to their lead.
Before halftime here.
Yep. Coppola in motion. He tried to come with a crisscross on the inside. Snuffed out there.
Nothing
good
doing.
Job. Yep.
Yeah.
Good job by the Giants to make the tackle in the back for a loss. So Reed Hassel is having a big night tonight. I think that's like his third tackle for loss. Okay, Blue Streaks sending some receivers out. One to the right, two to the left. Single back in the backfield. No, two. Doubles on both sides. In motion is number 34. They give him the handoff, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. Looks like Brent Quietnen, number 63. Yes. So nice job by Brent Quietnen. He's been in the backfield a few times tonight. So the Giants have been making some nice plays on defense. Unfortunately, they've given up some long runs, though, too. So it's kind of negated the nice plays they've had. Third and long. Again, doubles on both sides. Two slot receivers. Single back in the backfield. In motion, Surla. Back to pass, straight drop back. He's being pressured. Coming up the right side, fakes the pass. And he runs out of bounds at about the 23.
That brings up fourth down.
Going to be fourth down and eight. Think they're going to try a field goal?
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? Okay. I believe you're right. Okay, so fourth down and eight. From the Giants 24. Again, two wide receivers to each side of the field. Out of the shotgun formation this time. And they switched it up. Yep, they have both backs back there with their hands out. Somebody got chopped. Here's the pass deep into the end zone. And a nice job by the Giants to knock the pass away. So the Giants will take over on downs, first and 10 from the 24.
And we have a flag, yep.
Guess I spoke prematurely.
We have a flag on the play.
Doggone it. Some more flags. Oh, okay, legal chop block. The penalty is declined, and it will be the Giants ball on the 24. All right, we'll see if the Giants can put a drive together here before halftime. Minute 21 to go. And a lot of real estate to cover. Okay, got two receivers out here to the left. Back to pass. Yeah, looks like they're sacked.
Nothing going there.
And the Blue Streaks say they have the ball, and they did. But I think
he was down before.
Down before he took it.
Looks like we have some young cheerleaders going to come out onto the field here at halftime.
Oh yeah, yeah, that could be interesting. Okay, a single wide receiver here to the left, two receivers to the right. Out of the tee in the backfield. Quick slant, no good. Incomplete pass. Intended for Adam Erie. So it'll be third down. 37.7 seconds to go here in the first half. Giants trailing 38-6. Well, we knew something was up when they took the opening kickoff and ran it all the way back for a touchdown.
Touchdown,
And then we came back and answered it, but...
they haven't been able to muster anything else.
Nope, nothing since.
Turnovers.
Again, Baribou rolling out to the right, and
down he goes.
Looks like he's sacked again for another loss. Looks like he's sacked all the way back on about the 2 or 3 yard line. It's really hard to tell from here. Clock is running.
And that should do it,
and
huh?
That should do it here for the first half. I don't see him running another play. I don't think they want to risk having a safety called. And the clock is just running down. So they're going to run it out. 2-1. And there it is.
That'll
halftime.
Do it. Yeah.
So there we have it. So the score, Chisholm Blue Streaks 38. Mesabi East Giants 6 at the half.
So we can stay on a little bit here and watch the young cheerleaders, but I don't know, Bill, 4 turnovers, and it's really hard to score points when you do that.
It is, because if you don't have the ball, you're probably not going to be scoring, and we got to make up a lot of ground.
Yep.
God, and it doesn't seem like so far that we have one of those quick strike offenses. You know, it's more of a grind it out type of an offense, and you're down by this much.
Yeah, and the Giants were picking up first downs,
Yeah, we're moving down the field. We got to go over and get some stats here from Chris Shuck. Looks like our cheerleaders are bringing out some young potential cheerleaders who've got some kind of a routine that they're going to do.
There's a lot of them.
Yeah.
That must be the whole elementary school.
Practically, I think, yeah. Wow. They just keep coming. They're setting up some kind of a formation here. My guess is they're going to spell something out. What do you think?
Well, I think they do this in lines, so everybody's got a chance. There's not so many in one line and many of them, so
okay.
Many lines.
All right.
Yeah. Well, out of that bunch, they should get a few future cheerleaders,
I'm sure there will be, yes. How exciting for those kids to be out on the football field.
Yeah.
And I'm sure all the parents are up there and see cameras flashing and pretty neat.
Oh, yeah.
And of course, our cheerleaders really do a nice job too. Okay, they're doing a cheer. Well, I think I know that cheer.
Yeah, I think so too.
Giants, and then eat them up.
Here we go, a little routine.
Yeah, you can kind of hear the music going.
It's hard for me to pick out the song, though.
Yeah. Our loudspeaker system's not really exactly blaring it out. Well, they're getting some jumps in and all kinds of neat stuff. Fun for those little kids, though.
Oh, you bet.
I don't know what grade those are supposed to be, but from here, it looks like they're probably, third and fourth graders, maybe?
Well, I think I think they can be preschool, and because I think there was a sign up in school from preschool to whatever grade, fourth grade maybe, third grade.
Okay.
Well, I should say kindergarten, not preschool, but kindergarten on up.
Okay.
They look like frogs.
Yeah. All right. Nice job.
Well, looks like they're having fun out there.
Yep. All right, looks like they've finished up their program.
Program there.
And they're holding hands and walking off the field.
Okay. And we're going to take a little break.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Okay, and we're back here at Dolan Field in Aurora. Bill Crete and Barney Kokel. The Giants are a little bit behind, 38-6. But hopefully, maybe they can get something going in the second half here, Bill.
Hey, all we got to do is control the clock, eliminate turnovers, and make some tackles. And
yeah.
There you have it.
And, yeah, and keep the turnovers, though. And they had four in the first half.
Four in the first half. And, of course, the Blue Streak scored on all four of those turnovers, as usually is the case. But for the Blue Streaks here, we have some stats compiled by Chris Shuck for us. Sophomore Tyler Copeland, number 36, had four rushes for 78 yards. And number
That's a pretty good average.
That's a pretty good average. And then number 31, junior Grayson Hartshorn, had three rushes for 37 yards. And for the Giants, we had Levi Skelton, four rushes for 18. Alex Marfiot, 12 rushes for 78, which isn't a bad first half.
No.
And then John Gravett, three rushes for 12 yards. And here we go, kickoff here for the start of the second half. Quickly picked up by Adam Erie, cuts up the left side, turns a little bit left, and makes a nice return up to the 41-yard line. So we got a good field position to start the second half, Barney. Trailing 38-6. But, you know, it really wasn't a problem. We moved the football in the first half when we hung on to it. It's when, you know, we turned it over, we had some issues. And so all we got to do is just hang on to the football, make some plays, and get in the end zone a couple of times, make some stops, and we can be back in this game. So it isn't totally over. All right, wishbone offense for the Giants. Adam Erie out wide to the left. Tyler Baraboo under center. Takes a snap, fakes a handoff to the fullback, and we got another fumble.
But
it looks like Alex Marfiot was able to recover it back at the 36-yard line. So with the turnover, well, it's not a turnover, but with the fumble, it moves the ball back. Loss of four. So it's going to be second down and 14.
You know, and I don't know if Baraboo started last week for the Giants or not. I'm not quite sure. But, you know, when you have when you're in ninth grade and you're a little bit on the young side, trying to get that handoff in there, it takes time. It does.
Yeah, and I don't know if that's a handoff or if that's a pitch. And whatever it is, you're just not making a good solid connection with it, that's for sure. There's a nice run off the left tackle by John Gravett. Looks like he picked up about 5 yards. So we're going to have third down and about nine. So it was a nice quick little hitter, and the guard and the tackle made a nice little hole for him to run through. Once again, receiver out to the left, tight end on the right side, wishbone backfield. Oh, nice quick hitter to the fullback, straight ahead.
Good run there.
Yep, looks like he picked up a good 5-6 yards. So it's going to make it fourth down in about three or four. And so decision time here, we're just about to midfield on the 47-yard line. Do we punt it or go for it?
Yeah, you got about a good 4 yards, 3.5.
Looks like we're going for it, so there's our answer. We're on the left hash mark, receiver out wide here to the left. Going for it, fourth down. Hand off to Marfiot.
Nothing
going.
Up
to the right side, and he picks up about a yard before he's piled up there by a bunch of blue streaks. And so the blue streaks will take the ball over on downs in the Giants' territory.
Well, at this point in time, when you're down 38-6, you have to give it a try.
Yeah.
You bet.
What's the difference right now, really? Other than it's early in the second half here, we want to get some momentum, but see if the defense can pick them up here.
They pick up the first down, which they have been able to do tonight.
Mm-hmm. First and 10 from the Giants' 49-yard line. Blue streaks running their usual tight formation here. Single back in the backfield, couple of wings on the side. In motion, Copeland. Quick handoff to the fullback here, Hartshorn. Grayson Hartshorn running down the left side and piling up some more yardage. So just what we didn't want to see. Going to be first and 10, no flags on the play.
Picked up a pile.
So it's going to be first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Blue streaks on the left hash mark, going left to right. Here in the second half from Dolan Field in Aurora. Beautiful night for football. In motion is Skirla. Skirla gets the pitch, rolls to the left. Giants string it out. Looks like he maybe picked up about three. Still in bounce, so the clock will keep running. And Zach Skirla is a junior for the Blue Streaks. Skirla in motion, a little counter, over to number 34, Rudolph, who had just checked in. Didn't pick up much. Looks like it's going to be third down in about seven. Okay, from the 10-yard line here, 11-yard line. Third down and long. Okay, quick hitter, right up the middle. Nothing there. So the Giants did a nice job of stuffing it up, but we're in four down territory here.
Yeah.
So they're gonna have to make one more stop. Nice job by the Giants interior to plug that play up.
One more time here, Bill. And the only thing is, you got to start way back in your own.
Yeah, makes it for a long field.
Yep.
Rudolph in motion. And he gets the pitch. Hand off inside to Skirla.
Still going.
He's still going, yep. Yeah.
He's in the end zone?
Nope. Looks like he's just short of the end zone. But it should be a first down. Looks like he's down on the 1 yard line. First and goal from the one. That was a nifty little play. It looked like they were doing a pitch coming this way, and then he just did an inside handoff and come back with a counter in the other direction. Jackson Rudolph in motion, coming this way. Quick handoff to him. Dives straight ahead, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. So a 1 yard run by Rudolph. And it makes it 44-6 here with 6:37 to go in the third quarter. Looks like they're gonna try to kick the extra point.
Yeah, it's a good time, you know, you're got a pretty comfortable lead.
Yeah.
And why not try?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, practice up, yeah.
And this is better than practice even because, you know, this is live. All right, so to try to the extra point is going to be Corbin Jones. He's a sophomore, 5'5", 150 pounds. Holding it as the quarterback. The Scarbo, there's a snap, a little bit high, gets it down, and nothing there. It's blocked in the middle. So with that, it's going to be 44-6.
Well, the Giants will get the ball back. You're in the third quarter. Very nice evening.
Yeah.
This is football weather here.
Yeah, it really is.
It's not super cold. It's just a little bit maybe crispy. And
this is the type of weather that as a player out on the field, this is what you love.
Yeah.
Because you're not cold. You're a little warm from running and stuff, but you're not sweating. And yet you're not freezing.
And you can't see your breath yet.
So. No, so it's a good night for football.
Yeah, it isn't snowing.
Yep. All right, the Blue Streaks will be kicking off from left to right. Herman Jones tees it up on the tee, back deep for the Giants. John Gravett and Adam Erie. Here's the kick. Nice solid kick. Adam Erie with it on the left side, brings it into the middle, cuts it straight upfield, and he's blown backwards at the 31. So the Giants will take over, first and 10. Trying to get some offensive momentum going here. Okay, one wide receiver out to the left. Wishbone formation in the backfield. Quick straight ahead play to Levi Skelton, and he picks up a yard or two. Second down and about 8. Ball at our own 35-yard line. Okay, two wide receivers to the right, one to the left. Quick pass, and it's overthrown.
And that stops the clock.
That'll stop the clock. It'll be third down now and 7.
Well, next week I do believe Deer River comes to town.
Wow.
And that isn't going to be any easy game either.
Deer River is a perennial power in football. I know they lost one game so far this year to Braham, I think it is.
Braham, yeah, and Braham's top dog here.
Yeah.
Here they come.
Here's the blitz, and looks like we got another fumble. Yep, and with the turnover, it goes back over to the Blue Streaks.
That would be number 5 for the Giants.
Yep, and right at the Giants' 35-yard line, so short field for the Blue Streaks again. It's just a big pile in there. I had no idea who it was.
No, yeah, it's hard.
You
can't tell, yeah.
Try to get some names out here, but it's just, it's hard to see, and then boom, it's so quick, and
yeah.
And all of a sudden, who was it that had it? And can't see it. All right, in motion is Jones. He gets the pitch, cuts up the right side, and he's knocked out of bounds about the 26-yard line. So a nice little run there by the sophomore. So Blue Streak starting to sub in some younger players to get them some playing time. Yeah, they come up to the line here. They got second down and 2. In motion is Skirla. Straight ahead handoff to Copeland. Copeland tries to cut it to the outside. He fumbles.
And the Giants get it back.
Yep, and the Giants recover the fumble. So finally we get a turnover back.
Yeah, and that's the first turnover tonight for the Streaks.
Okay, Reed Hazel gets a fumble recovery. And the Giants will have the ball first and 10 from their own 25-yard line. Midfield. Well, let's see if we can get some momentum out of this now and move down the field. We've got two wide receivers to the right. Corvette's in the slot. Brennan Scott is out wide. Hand off straight ahead.
Not much going there.
Picks up a couple yards, maybe three. Who's that with the carry? I think it was Skelton. Second down and 8. Ball's on the right hash mark. Uh-oh, we're going to have illegal procedure on the Giants. Somebody jumped. Well, up until this point, we've actually played a pretty clean game.
Yeah.
Well, not that many flags. Four to six here. 4 minutes, 33 seconds to go in the third quarter. Beautiful night for football. Chisholm Blue Streaks, Mesabi East Giants.
Friday Night Lights.
Mm-hmm. Quick pitch over to Marfiot. He's got some room. Can he turn the corner? Nope, not quite. Nice tackle there by the Blue Streaks, number 20. Number 20, Ian Pulford, sophomore. Came up and wrapped up Alex. Picked up about 6 yards. Yeah, maybe not quite six, three. Hoping.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like third down and about six. Seemed like he ran a lot further coming around this way, but he was going east and west instead of north and south. All right, from the left hash mark, Giants got double tight ends. Out of the wishbone, quick hitter. Looks like we might have got enough for a first down.
I think so, oh yeah.
So a nice run there by Levi Skelton running straight ahead. Looks like he picked up about 7 yards for a first down. Okay, so first and 10 from the 40-yard line. Wide receiver to the left, tight end to the right. Hand off to John Gravette. Picks up about 3 yards. Running off the right side. So we're picking up a little yardage, controlling the ball. Ball's on the right hash mark. Here comes the blitz.
Nothing going.
Nothing there.
Stuff stood up and went backwards.
Yep. Okay, so a loss on the play. Gonna make it third down. About 8. Giants still on their side of the field. Double wide receivers. Back to pass, chased out. Got some room, gonna get there. No, And he stood up here on the sideline. All right, so we're going to have fourth down. Fourth down and about five. So we'll see here. Don't think we're going to punt. I think we're going to go for it. Why not?
Why not?
Minute and two to go here in the third quarter. And the Giants still in the wishbone. Pitch out to Marfiot. Looks to the right side. Nothing there. Cuts it back to the inside. No gain and loss on the play. It'll go over on downs to the Blue Streaks. Just nothing there. Okay, so the Blue Streaks will start first and 10 from their own, or from the Giants' 41-yard line.
Must be, of course, they moved the change to the other side. Time clock must have stopped by now.
Yeah, you have to stop the clock so they can get the change moved, and as soon as they do, then they'll wind the clock. In motion, quick pitch over to Jones. Makes one tackler miss, but he's picked up by Gravett. Gravett comes up and makes a nice shoestring tackle.
Yeah, loss on a play there, Bill.
Yeah.
Back him way back.
Way up. I still remember old coach from high school, even if we drop him for a yard loss, too much. You know, he always wanted a 5-yard loss or more on every play. Boy, that was hard to do. Okay, so there's the horn sounding the end of the third quarter. It's the Chisholm Blue Streaks 44, the Mesabi East Giants 6.
Well, let's see now. Giants score most of their points.
Yeah, we've outscored our opponents in the fourth quarter, 32-6. So maybe we can continue that here and score a bunch. Beautiful night for football. We got the barbecue smells coming from the concession stands over there.
That is for sure.
Never did get a chance to go over there and partake of anything, but sure smells good. You see, we're getting a plug for our show here.
A plug?
Right now, yeah. They're just telling the fans they can get us on Channel 2.
Oh. A plug from Dave.
Yeah, plug from Dave. We'll give him one back.
Right? Oh, yeah, you bet. Yeah.
He's our public address announcer here, Dave Hillman. He does a wonderful job.
So, fourth quarter starts.
All right, fourth quarter starts. We got second down and 12 from the Giants' 42-yard line. Blue Streaks running their double tight end. In motion is Jones. Quick dive straight ahead. And a pickup of about 10 yards. And see who that was. Looks like number 40.
You're just going to be short here.
Yeah, new guy, Cody Ullman, ninth grader. picked up some nice yards, 10 yards. Third down, 3 it looks like. Okay, motion, a little counter. Yep, Eric Willett almost had a tackle in the backfield, but kind of let him slide away.
Now he got the first down on that second effort there.
Yep, Ian Pulford with the carry. Got the first down, so it'll be first and 10 from the 30-yard line for the Blue Streaks. And the Blue Streaks trying to use up as much time as they can of the clock. You can see they're turning, looking to see how much time was there. Quick pitch out to number 11. Going around the right side, the Giants string him out, but he still picks up about 3 yards. Ball came loose, but the official says no, he's down. That's Eli Sundquist, a ninth grader, on the carry for the Blue Streaks. Tech. Tackled by number 7, John Gravett. Ball's on the right hash mark, second down and 7. Okay, Blue Streaks again. Really tight formation. Sundquist fumble. In motion, got a fumble, and he just took a knee and downed it. So the pitch wasn't handled, and the fumble was picked up. Joel Escarbo, quarterback, senior, just took a knee. Clock continues to run, 9 minutes and counting here in the third quarter. Blue Streaks up 44-6.
No.
Third down and 12.
When is it, or if it does, is there running time here?
I believe there is running time, but I don't think they have a big enough lead to do that yet. But I don't know how much it is. Okay, looks like I got a fumble in the interior of the line. It's going to be fourth down. Looks like fourth down and 12. And of course the Blue Streaks are going to go for it. Why not? On their own 38. Or on the Giants 38, excuse me.
Nothing going there.
Nothing there, no. So the Giants will take over on downs. It'll be first and 10 for the Giants. They're going to be starting at their own 35-yard line. Well, let's see if we can get a drive together and get some more points on the board. Double tight ends. Wishbone formation. Tyler Baraboo under center. Couple of subs coming in late for the Blue Streaks. Nice run by Gravett. He kind of got spun around there.
Yeah, he got pulled on pretty hard.
Yeah. Well, but he picked up 5 yards. 6 yards, actually. So it'll be second down and 4. Okay, wide receiver lined up to the left. Out of the wishbone. Blue streak showing blitz. Back it off. Quick hitter up ahead to Marfiot. Cutting to the left. He's coming around the corner.
And I think he... Oh my gosh, he almost made her.
He almost broke it, but not quite. So a nice run there by Alex Marfiot. Looks like he picked up about 10, 20, 30, 40, well, almost 50 yards that, on that play.
That definitely put him over the 100-yard mark.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Nice run. Nice blocking.
Yeah, it sure is fun to watch him run. He does a nice job reading the blocks, too. All right, so it's going to be first and 10, I believe, from the 11. So they can still get a first down before they get in the end zone if they need it. Dive straight ahead. Okay, Levi Skelton with the carry. Like he's tackled down around the 5. Second down and 5. Okay, we got wide receiver way out to the left. Tight end here on the right side, out of the wishbone. Quick hitter. Nope, faked it off. Crevet with it, and he's got no place to go with it.
Yeah, stacked up and probably a little bit of a loss there.
Mm-hmm. Big loss. So backing up is going to be third down and about 11. Ball's on the left hash mark. Quick pitch, Murphy out here to the right side, cutting it up. And he got a shoestring tackle down to the 5. So it's going to be fourth down. Nice run by Alex that time off the right side. Couple blocks. Could use one more. Okay, so we got a wide receiver to the left, two wide receivers to the right. Brennan Scott out wide right, John Gravett in the slot. Back to pass, Tyler Baraboo throws.
Incomplete.
And incomplete.
And no interference, no flags.
No flags. So with that, the ball will go over on downs back to the Blue Streaks. So it's going to be first and 10 from the 6-yard line.
And how much time?
And we got 3 minutes and counting.
3 minutes and counting down.
44-6.
Is it Blue Streaks? Is the clock running?
Clock is running.
Yeah, see, maybe it's running time now.
No, they're calling the clock. Stop the clock.
Well, someone called a timeout. Timeout Chisholm.
Okay, timeout Chisholm. Okay.
That's the first time out of the game.
First time out of the game, and I'm sure the coach took it here
just
because he's subbing in a lot of different players.
Right.
So he's trying to make sure he's got everybody in their right spots and make sure they know what to do, because they've been playing some ninth graders here in this fourth quarter. Yeah, and I'm sure he's trying to get everybody into the game. So you got a busy weekend lined up, Arn?
Yeah, a busy weekend. I'm building a sandbox for my daughter's twin boys. They just turned 2 the other day, and Grandma and I said, well, instead of trucks and toys, we'll build you a sandbox.
There you go. That'll be fun for the kids.
So I got it half done now, so I just got half left.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a little past their birthday, but...
Yeah. So how old are the boys?
Two.
They're two. Oh, perfect age for a sandbox.
And they got a bunch of trucks to put in it, so...
Okay.
So it'll get used.
All right, here's the Blue Streaks, first and 10. Sweep to the right. And is tackled out there by the Giants, strung out pretty well. Looks like number three, Aaron Collins, with the tackle for the Giants. So the Giants got some subs in here too in the fourth quarter. 2 minutes and 19 seconds and running. Here come the Blue Streaks on the right hash mark. On the 8 yard line, second down and 8.
Fumble. Well,
tried to run the counter here and they had a fumble. No sign yet whose ball. Looks like it's going to remain with the Blue Streaks, so it'll be third down and 7. Oh, well, loss on the play, third down and 9. Clock is running, minute 20. Again, both teams with a lot of subs in there now. Third and long. Straight ahead handoff. Plugged up by the Giants real well in the middle. So it's going to be fourth down and 10.
Fourth down
from
and
the
ten.
Five. From their own 5. So now are they going to punt or are they going to go for it, Barney? 39 seconds, 38 seconds.
Well, they can almost...
just run out the clock.
Run out the clock here. And if they had to, you take a penalty and...
Yeah. Yeah, I think it looks like they're just going to take this snap right here and that'll be the end of the...
Take a knee?
End of the game. No, they weren't going to take a knee because they want to keep the clock running, so they're going to run a play. Oh, they're going to pass it.
Oh.
Oh, an incomplete pass and it's going to stop the clock. Well, it should have stopped the clock. Clock's still running.
No, see, it must be running time now.
Okay. Yep. I'm not sure where that went in there at, but... All right, so there we have it with the final score. It's Chisholm Blue Streaks 44, the Mesabi East Giants 6.
And the Blue Streaks are going to up their record to 3-2 on the year. That's 3 straight wins now for them. 3 big lopsided wins.
Yep.
And the Giants are going to fall to 1-4.
1-4.
1-4. So, and they have Deer River next week. And I'm not sure who Chisholm has, but okay, it's going to be another tough game for the Giants.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough game and a homecoming game, too.
And a homecoming, so. But, of course, we don't have any stats, and that'll do it for here at Dolan Field.
All right, Barn. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. And everybody have a good evening.
Yep. Good night, everybody.